very quickly, 4 to 5 minutes.
That's all.
That's all.
You want your tiles very hot. If I see the preheat light go off, I still give it 10 to 15 minutes because it's very hot tiles.
I see they're kind of blistered. Oh, they're coming? Starting there already. Well, there's a big blister in there.
I think there's nothing funner than watching them come up.
I love them.
Because you get all that action so fast. I tend to like crispier bread, harder surfaces. Yeah. So I tend to overcook sometimes a little bit brown on surface, but if you like them softer, then you should pull them out a little bit before you see browning on the surface.
As soon as they puff, they're done?
Not quite.
Not quite.
I'd say 30 seconds after they've puffed, they can come out.
Gosh, well, they've all risen. Isn't that exciting?
Okay, let's pull them out.
Okay.
Oh, nice.
Oh, look, that, and you can see the
steam just coming out. And now if you're cooking, I stack them on top of each other, and then I put them in a towel. And that keeps them soft.
Oh, you don't care if they collapse?
I don't care if they collapse, because once you've created that pocket,
it's going to collapse anyway.
It's going to be in there anyway. You know, isn't that a beauty?
That's a beauty. That's marvelous, isn't it?
What I'm going to do is I'm going to put these over there and wrap them in towel with the others. Keep them warm.
I notice we have pans heating up here, too.
There's another way to make the same bread.
Well, good.
Yeah, I first realized that I could make pita in a skillet as I was living in Taiwan. And I couldn't find pita bread. Mm-hmm. And I could find whole wheat flour, but no bread. I have a small apartment, and all I had was a burner. So I started being around and realized that you make perfectly fine pita in a skillet. It's a little trickier, it's a little less dependable to make that pocket. But I have rolled this out, and I haven't turned my dough over. I've only rolled on one side. Mm-hmm. So I take the top surface, like they make chapati in India, and I take that top surface and I go down with it first.
So the top surface coming on top?
Yeah, for a very short time, for about 15 seconds. And then I'm going to turn it. Now you're going to ask me why I did that.
Yes, why did you do that, Seth?
The theory goes in India that you create that little bit of crust on that first side, and that allows it to hold in the steam. And when you have audibles beginning, you're going to turn it over and let it cook on the third side fully.
Well, this one's doing quite
well. That one's doing pretty well. You can see the puffiness.
Yeah, they are.
So let's go to the third side. Now, these are a little dry on the top surface. The pita on a skillet, you don't get the same effect as a big balloon.
No.
But you do, it is separating. See, now this one's almost in a balloon there.
Yes, it is.
After they've ballooned, I usually let them go for about 30 seconds to make sure. Nami's going to use exactly the same dough and make what is called in Turkey a lahmacun.
Well, let's call her in. Oh, is this the same dough that made by your husband?
Yes, yes. This is the pita dough, but it's been rolled out a little more thinly, and we're going to let those dough rounds sit there and relax. We may stretch them a little more before we finish. We're going to fill them.
Exotic something or other.
Well, yes,
with lamb.
With lamb, and we've got the ground lamb here, and we've got shallots.
Yep.
And what we're wanting to produce here is about a quarter cup of chopped shallots. But again, that's not. Precision isn't really the issue. You're just getting a flavorful sauce to dress the breads with. And then we'll just measure what I've chopped. We'll see how close we are. Oops. That looks fine to me. Yeah, there we are. There's a quarter cup. So now we've got some garlic. Now, again, we call for 3 cloves of garlic, but look at the size of this clove. So I think 2 will do.
Plenty of garlic.
Plenty of garlic. And I like chopping garlic, not pressing it. I don't know about you.
I don't care as long as we have plenty of
it. A lot of it. Now, just finish rinsing this garlic, and then we'll put some oil in that pan. We put in about a teaspoon of oil, and I just think a dollop will do it. Could you stir that oil around, spread it around the pan for me, please? That's great. Okay, and there you go. And we may perhaps need to turn that heat down a little, because we just want them to soften without getting too enthusiastic.
I'll turn it down.
Oh, great. And I'll dump in the shallots. So if you can keep an eye on that, I'll get the tomato dropped and it'll be set.
A nice smell of garlic and olive oil.
What is better? Let's just get rid of this before. Now, these plum tomatoes are quite tough. You know, there's much juice in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
And that's good because really they're going to cook down a little too. Really, you want the solid outside husk. Mm-hmm. Here, let's add this to the tomatoes. Now those tomatoes are going to sit there for a minute. This, how are those looking? They're softening. So let's tuck the lamb right in there. And the lamb is looking. See, it's minced lamb and it's fairly lean.
How much?
This is quarter pound. Put that in, and then we'll need to break those lumps up.
Mm-hmm.
So you break the lumps up a little, and just let the lamb get a little color.
And you could be vegetarian if you wanted not using lamb.
That's right. And if, for a vegetarian version, you perhaps instead of using 8 plum tomatoes of that size, you might use 10 or 12. And I'd up the shallots. I mean, you want to give it some flavor and body.
Well, put some eggplant. Or something.
You could put some eggplant in. So that's a good idea. Yeah. Now that brightens the brown.
Yeah, it does.
And now the tomatoes are going to have to cook a little because they're a bit thick walled.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll want them a bit softened.
Mm-hmm.
Now we can just let that simmer. If you can just keep an eye out. We're going to be cooking the breads on the pan and just need to lightly oil it. But if you have a nice big fat pastry brush like this one, it's sort of fun to play. This is part of the cooking job that our kids really like.
Yeah.
You know, playing with the oil. Now, this is thinner than those pitas.
Yeah.
And I'm going to stretch it a little more.
Sure.
Just pull it. They're nice and soft, aren't they? And you can sort of pull them around the edge a little bit and stretch them out.
Nice and soft,
isn't it? Pleasure to handle. Yeah. Now, we're close to done here. Let's just see. Are these tomatoes soft? Get in there. I'd like to leave them a few more minutes, but we can. Why don't we put the spices in, and then by the time we've done all that, we should be fine. Now, I like to use about 1/8 teaspoon of cinnamon. You don't really want the cinnamon to be the only thing you taste.
You don't want to taste and say, "Oh, cinnamon."
Oh, cinnamon. You know, you just want to sort of think, "What's that pleasantly elusive?" Yes. In there, and then the same amount of allspice.
Mm-hmm.
Which I find one of those mysterious tastes that you miss it if it's not there, but you never.
I never quite know what it is
when it's there. Now let's stir that in.
Does it get salt in?
And then we need some salt and we need some pepper. About 1/2 teaspoon of salt seems to do it. And then about 1/4 teaspoon of pepper. Now you can take peppercorns and, you know, grind them by hand. Mm-hmm. Or we can just be extremely generous with the pepper grinder. So now that's looking pretty soft. All right. And then the question of how much you use on bread is again a matter of preference. I like mine quite smeared. Jeff likes his a little sparer. Well, you're going to put it straight into the oven. You see, you can smear it nice and close to the edge. Now, pine nuts,
goody.
See, we didn't have to roast them because it's going straight into the oven. So, and again, it's a matter of your pleasure. I like pine nuts, so
more
I
better.
Tend to.
They have a special taste too.
They really do, and a sort of richness when you bite into them. Yeah. They're getting expensive, so you can, you know.
Well, they are.
Do what you wish. All right, let's go.
Okay.
The oven's now at 450, and the rack is in the middle of the oven.
How long are they going to take?
It'll be about 7 minutes.
Good. Okay, it's all preheated. Let's see how these are.
Catch a whiff of them as they go past.
Lovely. Now we have a whole display of Eastern Mediterranean feast. You're going to start. You're going to show us how to do it.
The pita. I'm going to tear pita apart. Use it as a spoon, I think.
You really eat a lot with your fingers.
Yes.
Here,
The lentil salad.
With red pepper.
This is chickpeas.
I love chickpeas. With spearmint.
These are yogurt cheese balls, made from goat and one from cow's milk.
And these are recipes that are in the book that comes with this series. They're wonderful, so we'll know how to make these. Great.
We can also put a little cucumber on here and perhaps some herbs, right?
An important part of the Eastern Mediterranean table is the pile of herbs that are always there. You can just add a bit of mint or a bit of one of my favorites here is tarragon.
Now, have a taste. Jeff, want to show?
Yeah. I just open up the the pocket, and even tear the pocket apart, and push in with my finger and adorn it maybe with a little piece of mint, and it's
go
ready.
For it, Julia.
That's nice.
Now
how about these great pieces?
These lac majun, as they're called, they're lamb breads. Mm-hmm. Here, let's tear this one.
Mm-hmm.
And then, classic way, is to put a little mint on it.
Mm-hmm.
And then you can even, and perhaps a little cucumber. It's sort of a nice texture contrast. Mm-hmm. And then you just roll it. And you'll have that bit of pine in there as well.
Mm-hmm. Right. And I can taste that bit of cinnamon in there. It's interesting how those bits of spices change the whole thing. Oh, that's delicious.
Really,
thank you both so much. It was wonderful to see all that dough being made. I was thoroughly enjoying it. And thank you for coming over.
It's been a real pleasure.
It's been a pleasure for us.
A pleasure for me, too. Thanks a lot.
Complete recipes for all the breads, cakes, cookies, and pies in this series and more are available in the